Hello, my name is Siti Khadijah Haji Ismail, and you can call me Kitty. And I am one of the cybersecurity awareness trainer in Brussels, and I'm also as a security analyst in Brussels. And I've been working with Brussels around almost 12 years this year. Okay, here with me today, we have our facilitator, as lead trainer, Farid Aziz, and we have Naomi Pawi, Ida Frida, and Izwana Ayub. So if there's any questions, our facilitator, inshallah, will be answering your questions lah. Okay, moving on, a short introduction for CSB. CSB stands for Cybersecurity Brunei. Okay, Cybersecurity Brunei is actually established in August 2020. Since August 2020, CSB ada three services dalamnya. There's three core services under CSB, Cybersecurity Brunei, which is number one, Brussels. Brussels stands for Brunei Computer Emergency Response Team. So this Brussels team, okay, we call it a team pulang ya, Brussels. Brussels is actually role-nya is the first responder in Brunei if there's any incident related to IT lah, incident or threat lah kah. For example, macam in government, dia punya website-nya kena defacement, ada yang kena ubah-ubah dia punya homepage. So Brussels, yeah, Brussels team wanita yang turun to get the logs, okay? And then we also have National Digital Forensics Lab, we call in short NDFL. So for the NDFL ini is actually orang punya expert is kalau bis kita ada pen drive or hard disk yang ada datanya terdelete or hilang dia terus-terus, and then you want to retrieve your data back, so you can see our NDFL team manila ha, they can get your information back, okay? Depending on the situation jualah ha. Okay, and then the last services, we also have Cyber Watch Center. In short, we call it CWC. Okay, CWC kerajanya, their role is monitoring network traffic for the government masa ni lah, government network. We only see traffic saja yang masuk and yang keluar. For example, if there's a malware berjalan-jalan in the government network, and then this CWC will turun to get the logs and analyze it. Okay, so artinya kalau bis kita memakai WhatsApp using network government network atau kami ina nampak lah, we cannot see what you are adalah texting atau we just see the network traffic if there's any malware sejalah malware or incident threat yang happen in the government network. Okay. Okay, our topic today tadi pasal fake news ah. So what is fake news? Okay, I think bis kita pun mestinya tahu jua fake news ni ya. Artinya pun incorrect lah or misleading information ah. Okay, it can harm a person's or entity's reputation ah. Okay, so I think ani kita ni tahu lah fake news ni ya. Ganya kita ni sometimes in the berapa tahu how do we differentiate lah. This news ini benarkah ataupun it's just a viral news ah? Okay. Okay. There are two types of fake news ini when it comes to fake news. Okay. One, misinformation, and the second one is disinformation. Okay. Ini dua ini is different ya sebenarnya when it comes to fake news ah. Okay, next slide, I will explain lagi lah the difference between misinformation and disinformation. Okay. Okay, misinformation. Misinformation ni, there's no intention to harm or deceive. Nada niat untuk kan menakut-nakutkan, untuk menipu orang atau nada. Example-nya lah yang macam mana. Okay, there's examples of misinformation. Parody and then salah information ah, which leads to hoax, kabar angin. For example, misinformation ni last time ada viral juga about misinformation last time ada ni ada about the since COVID ni ada the viral on sorry ah sikit cepat apa ni last time ah COVID COVID. Okay, there's a, ada ni satu example. Sorry. I want to remember pulang apa. Okay, this misinformation ini basically, kita ni melihat ia punya headline pun macam hebat lah ha. Sensational headline. Macam membuatkan kita ni kan mengklik tadi headline. Tapi actually the content itu macam lain. The content itu bukan ia punya headline ni bah. Bukan the content of the headline sepatutnya lah ha. So for example macam kan macam examplesnya di sini is a parody. Ah. Parody ini selalunya ia kan just for fun saja. Okay, ini misinformation lah. Misinformation yang leads to macam just kabar angin lah, bukan kan menyakitkan hati orang lah. Nada efeknya ada orang. Okay, for this information ini ia ada intention kan menyakitkan orang, kan menipu orang, kan menjahati orang. Okay, for example the contentnya ni dorang manipulasi. Sekiranya tah ceritanya macam mana? Ceritanya macam mana? And then, mas kalau orang bertanya arahnya apa ceritanya, ditukar balikannya, diputar baliknya cerita tu. Jadi ini salah satu examples of disinformation. Okay? Okay. There are many different types of fake news di sini sebenarnya. Tapi I just want to share yang the most popular fake news sajalah ha. Different types of fake news. Okay. Okay, one is parody. Okay, I'm not sure pula, tapi I can guarantee some of you yang join this webinar this afternoon ni ada tahu yang this The Onion newspaper ni. So it's basically the Onion ni is The Onion ni is a popular publishing site in America. Intentionnya to humor ataupun sarcastic saja. Okay, however, some people would take their headlines ni seriously ah. So for example, di sini katanya in this picture, National Science Foundation Science Heart. Dia punya headline lain. Tapi the content pasal lain lagi diceritakan nak. Sometimes sebenarnya intentionnya diorang ni kan, you know, parody is just for fun saja. Tapi sometimes diorang kan sarcastic lah. Ada sense of sarcasm ni lah. Okay, these are the one of the different types of fake news. Okay, tapi sometimes ada juga yang melihat headline nak macam mana. Seriously, ya take seriously. Okay? So, ini is examples of fake news sudahnya. It's a parody ni. Okay, the second one is false connection. Okay. Caption do not support the content. So, as you can see here, ia punya gambar, ia, the headline-nya tu, ia begitu MH370. Okay? It's a Malaysian plane. Tapi katanya has been found near Bermuda Triangle. Tapi what you can see arah sini, in the picture, it's not MH370, bukannya is a Malaysia plane bah. Okay, so the caption does not support the content lah. Lain contentnya, lain dia punya gambar. Okay, this is false connection. Different types of fake news juga. Durang kan, as you can see sini juga, people use different photos ini is actually untuk men-attract ketani lah, supaya ketani mengklik on the photo. Okay, to attract us about the mystery airline MH370 ah. But actually ia punya foto ni from other source lagi ni orang dapat. Okay, if you have any question just post our question and answer session chat box ah. Okay, next one is imposter content. Macam mana, if you can see here it's a Borneo bulletin, tapi di dalamnya ada Wuchun di sana, Wuchun Latest Investment, okay? So genuine sources are impersonated karena tukar-tukar isi-isinya. Okay, for this one, Brunei Bulletin is one of the reliable sources in Brunei kan. Tapi ada some of people ni take advantage lah. Okay, the people put fake content and then masukkan nama dorang di dalam tu to make it look legitimate. Okay, is one of the fake news juga. Next one is pseudoscience. It's actually katanya di sini, as you can see here, vaksin dos keempat tidak diperlukannya. So, selepas mendapat dos ketiga, katanya boleh elakkan COVID-19 dengan minum air suam, campur dengan kayu manis, plus gula katanya. So, it's a scientific method ah, di sini. Ah. So, this is considered different types of fake news juga. So, katanya kena galakkan untuk mengambil second dos sudah kan, second booster kan. Tapi di sini katanya, indahnya tidak diperlukan. Okay? Minum saja, pakai saja scientific methodnya. So, you don't need the second booster. This is one of examples lah of the different types of fake news. Okay. So, actually yang ini not proven ya, belum lagi tanya tahu kesahihannya. It's just scientific method lah. Tapi we don't know, is it proven kah, indah kah? Okay. Okay, fake news anatomy. How to spot fake news? Okay, I guess petani ada yang selalu menerima fake news tapi anda tahu kan membezakan, is this fake news? Is it benar? Even arah Brussels pun kadang-kadang ada kena report juara kami kena they asking for ini benar kan ini cerita ini. Okay, now so today we belajarlah how to spot fake news. Okay, one example of okay, let's take this article for an example lah. Okay. Kita ni lihat di sini. If you bis kita tah melihat this type of news article, okay? So, one question arah kita ni we ask question lah, is it benar kan indah ni? Okay? So, what happened here? How do you spot the fake news ini? Okay? So, first thing first. Okay, ceritanya macam mana? Brunei is my favorite country. By Si Awang and then ada Harbulan, bla bla bla. And then katanya di sini, if you read dia punya artikel ni, katanya di sini, okay, yang di bawah lah. Mesti kita lihat lah. Brunei has a total population of around 4 million. Okay? Benarkah Brunei ada 4 million? Okay? So, ini pun sudah katanya tertanya-tanya kan? Benarkah ni? Okay? So, what you should do, first thing first, you need to know, you need to determine dulu ia punya URL. Okay? So, selalunya, di sini katanya https://www.updatenews.yahoo.com. If you notice, selalunya kalau kita ni melihat Yahoo punya news, ada ke indah update di depan newsnya tu, the URL tu. Okay, what I can show you. Okay, and di sini, https://news.yahoo.com. This one is legit kan? Tapi, di sini updatenews.yahoo.com. Okay, so you can see di sana ada nampak kan? Di sana sudah macam it's not usual lah, unusual lah domain name-nya. So updatenews.yahoo.com. Okay, so when you are browsing your if kita ada browsing your Safari and Google Chrome, make sure you check the URL-nya juga. Okay, familiar with the URL. Okay, so here, unusual domain name. Ya buat sana updatenews.yahoo.com. Itu sudah salah. Okay? Okay. Second thing yang kita ni tertanya-tanya dalam diri kita ni, can the information be found in other website? Okay? Okay. Di sini katanya tadi, as I said tadi, kalau bis kita baca, if you read this article, ya begitu sana sudah one thing for sure yang salah sudah informationnya about the population of Brunei. Okay, population of Brunei dia sampai million macam manilah yang estated esurangannya, es miniku statednya. So actually pun Brunei around 400,000 people saja. Okay, ini sudah satu salah. Ha? So sini, I want you lepas-lepasan ni, if you want to check either ya fake news ataupun indah, maybe you can check this content arah any other website. Kalau sekiranya terjumpa arah website lain, it's a high chance ia punya news satu reliable, ia punya source satu reliable lah. Ha? Tapi if nada jumpa arah lain, you see arah this article saja yang beritahu Brunei population is around 4 million. So di sini ada high chance-nya this article is fake. Okay? Okay. Next thing, you ask yourself, how did you find the article? Okay, di mana kita ni dapat this article sebenarnya kan before ni? Is it kita ni ada mengklik on the link kah? Or maybe ada dari pop-up kah advert arah PC kita ni keluar and then you baca because of the headline-nya Brunei is my favorite country kah? Okay, so kalau boleh lepas ni bis kita check lah headline-nya. Okay, headline-nya. Sometimes headline-nya ni, kalau fake news, dia punya headline-nya ni to get kita ni emotional reaction lah. Ha? So, headline doesn't always tell the whole story ya, actually-nya. So, kalau boleh, bis kita lepasan ni, melihat headline-nya, if you buka, check dah dia punya URL, and then check di mana source yang, di mana source reference yang ia dapat ni, there is information. Okay, so read a little further lah lagi ya before you decide, before you share this information arah orang lain lagi. Okay, takut ya indah sahih, indah benar karena buat-buat. So katanya share tahara orang berita yang indah benar. Okay, this can lead to kabar angin ataupun boleh menjadi apa, orang pun menjadi chaos lah, ha? Jadi huru-hara katanya just because of the ya punya information ini salah, tapi katanya viral-viralkan. Okay, so make sure lepasan ni bis kita check lah the URL, the headline and the source-nya ni dari mana yang dapat. Please check back, okay? Next one, source. Okay, selalunya ada artikel, every article yang kita ni baca-baca selalunya, mesti ada yang buat tu, dari mana sumbernya ya dapat. Okay, di sininya as you can see here, source Miniku. So, is it properly cited kan this Miniku ni? Okay, so ini kita ni mesti check lah ha. So news article should provide you with facts from various viewpoints. Okay, ini mesti kita ni check benar-benar lah ha, dari mana punya sumber-sumbernya. Okay. Okay, next one kita ni boleh check. Masa ni sudah Google ada support, ini sudah kan image search. So you can perform reverse image juga. So sekiranya tah this macam mana, Brunei is my favorite country. Ya bagi sana peta Brunei kentok. So luruskin dah ni peta Brunei. So if you want to check back, luruskin dah salah ataupun lurusnya. So you can Google this picture. Okay, you can Google this picture and perform image search lah on this image. So if ya ada found on another banyak artikel juga, so it could be high chance yang this photo ni kena pakai balik lah. Okay, kena pakai balik for this article. Okay, I hope you understand pulang ah. Reverse image ah, maksudnya di sini kita ambil image ni, search di arah Google this image. So it should be showing arah Google punya result atau dari mana ia dapat this photo, this photo, this photo. Okay. Okay, next one, check siapa yang punya authornya, siapa penulisnya. Okay, as you can see here, di sininya si Awang. Dia buat sana si Awang. So, petani kadang-kadang kalau news article masa ni, kalau petani, if you realize article masa ni, ada buatkan sana siapa penulisnya, dari mana sumbernya, ini ya. So kata ni kadang-kadang tani, ada yang tani familiar lah dengan penulis-penulisnya ni. Tapi I think ani kadang-kadang kata ni terlepas pandang juga tani. Dia jumlah kadang-kadang siapa yang menulis. Ya tak kadang-kadang ani satu salah satu kesalahan kata ni juga. Kata ni sepatutnya tani lihat ni siapa penulisnya. Tani mesti tahu siapa yang author penulis-penulis yang anilah yang credible lah. Okay, yang reliable. Okay. So before you see the article ni, before you share something information on it, so make sure you need to know siapa yang mempublish this news and then siapa yang men-share this news, okay? Buatlah ha, buatlah kajian sedikit lah, little research lah ha, before you believe this message ni, information ni lurus atau tidak, or before you delete this information. Okay? So make sure you look for unusual URL or site names. Okay, macam mana tadi update news. It should be news.yahoo.com instead of updatenews.yahoo.com. And then walaupun di sini ya, as you can see ya, ada HTTPS kan. Tapi HTTPS, it doesn't mean yang this information ini lurus ataupun tidak. Okay, it make sure yang HTTPS ini is just make sure yang this website is secure saja. Durang encrypt saja this information. Tapi actually, the information, the content of the article tu, ia mana beritahu tak? Ia semestinya lurus tak HTTPS ni. Okay. Okay. Next one. How can fake news harm us? Okay. Macam mana berita-berita palsuannya, maklumat palsuannya boleh mengharm katanya. Okay. Apa efeknya kata ni? Okay. Okay. One is chaos. If many people believe fake news ni, kita ni pun jadi paniknya. Macam last time masa COVID ada berita ada naik harga dia, okay? Bukan yang karena ni, yang karena ni memang benar lah ada naik harga. Tapi dulu ada naik harga, and then harga ERP ada seorang berjual murah, seorang berjual mahal, kena viral kan? Jadi time COVID ni kita ni menggunakan the kit kan, ERP kit. So di mana yang murah tani sana tentu panik tu semua orang membeli itu ini barang. Since COVID ani saja semua akan dibeli, disinfectant kan dibeli, sanitizer semua dibeli. Okey, semua mau je yang detol, tisu basah, mau je yang ada apa namanya, mau je yang ada yang 99% atau 99.99% ya get rid of the virus. Okey, panik semua orang membeli itu ini. Okey. Ini yang membuatkan tani jadi huru hara ni semua. Okay? Just yang tadi yang I share tu, it happens kan last time during the first wave of COVID, ada semua terjual-jual. And then the second wave COVID, ada jual viral pasal the AR ticket ni, dorang jual-jual murah, ada yang jual mahal. Okay? It can be chaos lah tanya, huru hara, panic and chaos. Di kedai-kedai pun usually, banyak habis barang terus since COVID last time, okay? The second one, harmful to health. Okay, kadang-kadang ada information, tanya ada receive kan, ada WhatsApp, kadang-kadang beritahu kalau kena COVID, buat ini, buat itu, buat ini, untuk siapa yang terkena COVID aninya, diorang bagi false information about medical treatment ini. So, for example, saya bagi katanya, siapa yang sudah yang terkena COVID, minum mana, makan mana, okay? So kita ni dah tahu apa yang punya apa namanya arah kesihatan kita ni, apa yang terjadi, kita ni dah tahu. So make sure if you receive this kind of information, buat kajian lah dulu. So you do the research lah sedikit lah. So kalau benar tak yang disampaikan itu, then kita boleh ikut, you can follow. Tapi if you feel macam, tapi di sini cakap yang aninya. Di sininya orang ini cakap aninya ada WhatsApp. Kalau ke Google, lain jawapannya lagi. Okay? So, nada related yang punya medical treatment ini. Indah dia sama. So, it can be harmful kita ni punya kesihatan. Ah. Okay? Boleh menjejaskan kesihatan kita ni. Okay. Kita ni pun membaca berita-berita cuman ni kadang-kadang memang kadang-kadang macam menjejaskan kita ni punya kesihatan lah ha. kalau petani membaca yang berita palsu cuma ni, tapi tanya anggap benar, tanya anggap serius bah. Okay, so what you have to know lepas ni, if bis kita menerima this kind of information, jangan diikut bulat-bulat terus. Do a little research. Okay, di mana bis kita dapat, di mana orang ni dapat. Kalau ya ada bagi resource-nya, bis kita agak sejarah resource-nya, di mana orang ni dapat this kind of information. Okay? Okay, financial loss. Okay, as I said tadi, believing in fake news that are related to finance may impact our decisions and cause financial loss. Macam tadi, ada awal-awal dulu air ticket memanglah kompetitif lah harganya. So semua takkan membeli. Sekali tiba-tiba sebenarnya harga market price-nya lagi murah daripada yang orang berjual-jual ni. Okay, it could lead to financial loss. Not even air ticket lah. Macam sekiranya tak face mask orang berjual. Since COVID inilah lah. So orang berjual mask-mask. Okay, ada yang berjual mahal, ada yang berjual murah. Okay, so jangan terlalu percayalah. Kalau boleh buat tah kajian dulu lah. Okay, so macam hari tu, since COVID ini juga ada apa namanya, petani berguna macam-macam barang. Okay, since now lagi, kes lagi naik, naik. So petani pun ready barang. Okay, so panik tak semua orang, mau jual ada Panadol di rumah. Ada one time tu, cari-cari Panadol di semua kedai pun banyak habis. Okay. And then balik ubat-ubatan ni sembuko semua kena no, semua kena balik. Okay, it could lead to financial loss. Okay, so make sure lepas ni bis kita kalau ada menerima walaupun menerima this kind of information, jangan panik terus ha. Okay, so make sure do a little research lah, jangan tak sudah kena begitu case tinggi okay ready ubat. Okay, ready tu memang ready lah. If you want to, bis kita punya sendiri punya anulah, inisiatif lah. If you want to get ready, tapi janganlah diborong semua macam-macam kan, sanitizer semua dibeli berapa puluh botol. Jangan tak diambil-ambil. Just anu saja, secukupnya saja dulu. Okay, because we don't want any happen anak bis kita. So make sure after this. Berhati-hatilah kalau menerima this kind of information, ah, fake news ni. Ah. Okay. Okay. Tips and precautions from Buser. So, lepas ni, kalau ada yang some of you yang menerima this kind of information lah. So, when receiving news, make sure you verify your punya source first. Jangan percaya bulat-bulat apa yang petani terima lah. Ha? Okay. So anything you see pun bukan semestinya benar. It could be salah juga, it could be benar. So that's why we want you to verify it first. Ya punya source. Di mana sumber-sumbernya. Jangan percaya benar-benar lah everything you see. Okay. And then when you forwarded photos. Okay. Masa ni tani pakai WhatsApp. Banyak yang message yang ada nampak forwarded, banyak many forwarded kereta message videos, yang video-video tu pun yang kena share tu pun petani mesti review juga with caution. Okay, berhati-hati ya, with caution mesti. Indah semestinya ia benar. Okay, it could be wrong, it could be right. Okay, so make sure you do a little research lah juga di mana sumber-sumbernya. Ini video ni benar kan ni yang cuma ini. Last time ada pasal there's a viral hari tu yang menyebabkan panic ni masa tu ada sekejap tu pasal if you heard about baras ketani plastic rice, ada these two foreigner buat video yang beritahu ketani punya local rice ni plastic. Okay, so last time sempat jual lah, myself pun sempat hari tu tertanya-tanya macam, ah plastik, takut kan makan nasi terus, panik jadinya. Okay, kan membeli nasi pun, kan makan nasi pun takut-takut pasal kena begitu viral, pasal viral itu. Begitunya ketani punya baras plastik. Takut kan ketani kalau sekiranya benar tak. Okay, so ada satu tu, it's a fake news lah. Baik juga lepas, dah lama lepas itu ada keluar statement lah from RBPF, Raya Brunei Police Force, ada mengatakan yang ini indah benar lah. Okay, so ini sudah example of fake news. So what you see, what you receive itu indah semestinya benar. So jangan tak percaya mana-mana lah, jangan percaya bulat-bulat lah. Okay, maybe with, mesti with caution lah. If you receive something, tertanya-tanya lah arah diri kita ni, apa ni, dari mana, kenapa aku menerima ni, okay? So ini mesti tanya-tanya arah diri kita ni. Okay, so and then next one, do not forward message or delete them if they seem fake. Okay, macam yang tadi, as I said yang Baras tadi. So macam, kenapa ya Barasnya kena begitu plastik viral kan hari itu, sampai ini banyak ni grup, dalam grup-grup WhatsApp pun semua I receive this type of video. And then ada lagi dengan muka-muka yang membuat video ni kena viral kan. Okay, so jangan jangan kalau boleh, kalau benda ni dah benar, stop dah viralkan. Okay, stop forwarding this kind of messages. Before you share arah orang lain, arah family, so make sure you do a little research lah dulu. So if tak sekiranya bis kita yang receive this kind of information, boleh bis kita tegur lah arah orang tu. So kalau boleh janganlah percaya bulat-bulat. Anu tah dulu, just do a research, benar kinda apa buktinya yang beritahu yang plastik tadi punya nasi ni plastik. Okay, jangan tah sekali, jangan tah if you receive this message, forward lah ada grup ni semua grup kena forward. Okay, and then tah jadinya huru hara Brunei, jadinya panik semua orang. Okay, myself pun masa tu panik lah sekejap, tapi nyaman sikit hati lah lepas ada keluar a statement from RBPF atau yang saying that this this rice ni bukannya plastik. Okay, so di sana pun tadi dapat pengajaran yang jangan percaya benar-benar lah. So please make sure after this you baca, you check if you want to make sure yang this this information ni benar ataupun tidak. So make sure you check the URL nya dulu. Okay, check URL nya. And then maybe you can Google dia punya URL atau dua. If ada keluar banyak source lain-lain, so high chance-nya ia it's not reliable lah, reliable sources lah. Ha? So if tak sekiranya orang ini saja yang mempost this kind of information, so indah terrelay itu usulnya. Okay, so make sure stop deh, jangan takkan di share or forward orang-orang. Okay. So we move on. Okay, what can you report to Pusata? So we're coming to end pulang sudah this webinar. What can you report to Pusata? Okay. There are many related issue related yang cyber incident where you can report to us. For example, macam kalau infected computer. Kalau bis kita punya computer ada infected by virus ataupun worm or trojan ada found arah kita punya computer, you can call us, you can report to Buset. And then what we can do is we bagi advice lah, we can assist you from there lah. Macam kalau sekiranya infected computer, we can advise you to install antivirus, scan with antivirus, tapi make sure your antivirus is updated. Okay, next one, malicious website. Sometimes katanya when we are browsing internet, browsing using Google Chrome ka, Safari ka, Edge ka, Mozilla, anything lah, any browser you use. Ada tu sometimes kalau kita ada menginstall antivirus ataupun plugins, ya ada beritahu tu, this website is is ada malicious lah, ada tu, ya sebenarnya ada dibuatnya yang red tu. Okay, so ia punya option di bawah tu ada yang begitu back to safety, and then ataupun you want to continue search the website. So make sure kalau bis kita teragak tak arah malicious website, so make sure you click on the back to safety, jangan diteruskan. Okay, and then what can you report to us? You can, kalau bis kita punya email kena hack, usulnya, if you think you cannot access your email on that time, macam kena ubah password, macam kena tukar passwordnya, so you can report to us job. Okay, what we can do, we assist you from there to reset your password and of course ada lagi steps and kami punya procedure lah lepas itu. Okay, fishing. Fishing juga, you can report to us. Fishing bukan menangkap ikan lah. Fishing di sini is a fishing macam menangkap ikan juga, tapi menangkap information. Okay, kalau ini, kalau fishing ikan, tadi menangkap ikan. Kalau fishing ini, kita ni menangkap information. Okay, let's say di sini fishing ini selalunya memakai social engineering teknik lah. So for example lah, macam kita ada menerima this kind of email. And then you suruh katanya click on this link. Kalau kita ada pernah terklik on this link, yang blue link ini diklik untuk reset password sekian-sekian, maybe daripada bank kah, dari mana. So you can report to us. Huh? Okay. Business email compromise, selalunya it happens arah company pulangnya. Not only company and government sector lah. Huh? Macam yang selalunya BECN-nya orangnya the scammer ni, ia claim ia as a CEO selalunya. CEO ataupun the minister lah ha, yang paling atas lah. And then dia punya purpose of the BEC ni, ia suruh mentransfer money. So sekiranya tak dia CEO ngam ia belayar. So ia beritahu, so this scammer ia akan pakai this CEO punya email address saja without hacking. Yang dah hacking, ia memakai email address saja. Okay, this ABC ya. Ia memakai this email untuk mengantar email arah from one of the employee arah company ni. Selalunya, this scammer target finance department. Okay, pasal diorang mau transfer money urgent. So, di sini kata the scammer ni yang claim dirinya as a CEO. So, ia di emailnya arah this finance katanya, hi nya, please transfer this sum of money lah tu, ada yang begitu this sum of money arah my bank account ni. So ia bagi detailnya terus. So if sekiranya this finance people ni indah tak this employee ni indah memverify balik arah this CEO, it could lead ia mentransfer money. So the one who receive the money itu bukannya CEO, actually the scammer. So if bis kita tak pernah encounter this type of email, pernah receive this kind of email, it's a bit easy, you can report to us juga. Okay? So for social media, masa ni we receive banyak sudah report to Buset on social media. Ada yang kena apa namanya, anything related to social media lah. Social medianya kena ambil gambarnya untuk buat fake profile baru, okay, yang catfishing and all that, you can report to Busuju, okay? Cyberbully pun jua. So if anything, your kids di sekolah, bis kita pernah terdengar yang anak kita tu kena bully di sekolah ataupun in terms of cyberbully, dia nulata through WhatsApp, through Instagram, Facebook, through any platform, online platform manilah, ha? Atau we consider is cyberbully, so you can report to us. Okay? So next one is what you can report to our website defacement. As I said today, website defacement, sekiranya tabis kita ada website, and then your website atau kena tukar-tukar yang punya interface-nya. Kena, macam in this case, kena bagi tak tulang cuma ni. Okay? Kena bagi you have been hacked. So di sana ada website defacement, so kena hack ia punya website, so you can report to us, okay? Jangan takut lah untuk mereport ke Buset. Your information tu kami record to our system sajalah untuk kami reveal to public, okay? And the last one, what you can report to us is denial of services. So denial of service ni is actually if you want to browse this website, sekiranya tanda ada information you receive, it could be DOS attack happen. So you can report to us. Okay? So let's say government punya website you cannot access, and then you cannot dapat apa-apa information. So you can ask arah kami juga, we can check with you. Okay? Okay, how can you report cybersecurity incident? You can email to us reporting@buset.org.bn. So You can report jua through our anu jua through our website ah sebenarnya jua. So you can email to us reporting at brussel.org.bn and then you can call us jua 245-8001. We have 24/7 punya apa namanya help desk ni untuk mengangkat telefon kalau kita ada subuh-subuh ka, we can answer jua for you. And then if malu-malu tah kan mengcall Brussels kan mereport to Brussels, we have another help desk jua helpline 717-0766. Okay, remember this number 717-0766. Make sure yang bis kita kan report ani it's a incident cyber security related. Okay. Okay, last one, you can browse our website jua www.secureverifyconnect.info. So any information yang we share today ni pun ada arah our website ah actually-nya. So if you want to browse jua kami punya website sini, you can go secureverifyconnect.info. Di sana what you can do sana, we ada bagi tips lah jua untuk bis kita. And then we also ada video arah YouTube channel kami pun ada jua if you want to see video on our apa namanya cybersecurity related lah ha, videonya scam video anything lah yang related to cybersecurity ni ada we share tu. Okay, so please don't forget to anu jua. Okay, if you have any question, you can type in our chat box juga.